So we're starting out with a little bit of our, we love our copper olive oil. And they have some great flavored olive oils that can really, you know, take your soups and stews to the whole level. A mushroom and sage olive oil that would be wonderful in this recipe. Okay, so I've got 1 cup of diced onion. And most soup stew recipes start out with the mixture of onion, carrots, and celery, and this is 1 cup each. And if you go a little heavy on the vegetables, that is not a problem. I actually like to do lots of extra vegetables. So I'm cutting up some celery, and it doesn't have to be perfectly finely chopped. So Arlo, when they put a dog under for teeth cleaning, or I guess, in, you know, just like you put people under, you can't give them food or water past, it was 8 o'clock last night. So it was felt so bad to take his water bowl away, and then I was kind of worried that he was going to find water in other places, if you know what I mean. He did drink out of the Christmas tree stand one time. Well, he had water in his bowl, but I think he was confused, like, oh, there's water right here, until we told him no. But anyway, so I had to keep him away from water. And this morning, he kept following me around, like, this is normally the time you feed me, Mom. Where's my food? So everywhere I went, he was like, he almost came into the shower with me. You know, I was like, no, no, no. But he's like, Mom, I'm hungry. So I know, I felt so bad. No food, no water. Even had to watch it, so I don't, you know, does that mean snow? Because when I let him out this morning, I'm like, no, you can't eat the snow either. All right, so I'm just softening my vegetables here. Really important with soup is to season as you go. So a little salt and pepper. I can tell it needs a little more oil. And this really is gonna give this soup some great flavor. So salt and pepper. Big night out. Are we doing that right now, Abby? Okay, I'm so excited about our next big night out. You've been asking. Well, we've got an amazing big night out coming up. Now, here are the details. You can go get the full menu on our website, but it's coming up on Monday, February 9th, and we're headed to the Appleton Beer Factory, which is on College Avenue in Appleton. It's the price is $60 per person. But this is going to be over the top amazing. Several different courses paired with your choice of wine or beer. Some of the menu items, crab cakes, pork osso buco served with polenta, an amazing dessert. This is a great restaurant anyway, and the menu that they put together is really, really fun. A salmon carpaccio is an appetizer to start things out. So I know this one is going to book up very, very quickly because this is such a great restaurant and the menu is over the top good. So limited spots, you know, available for this. So I would call right away to reserve your spot. And the number is right there on the screen, 920-364-9931. And again, several course meal paired with your choice of their house-made beer, or if you're not a beer drinker, that you can also get wine with your dinner. So anyway, it's going to be a really fun night. Okay, so our mushrooms, it's a mushroom barley soup slash stew, very, very thick. So the onion, the carrot, and the celery are going. Now we're going to do some fresh garlic. I still can't believe that Packers game. It was one of the most exciting games and scary. Not sure if I have many fingernails left toward the end there. It was a little too close for comfort, but they did it. And now here we go to Seattle. Can hardly wait. One of my best friends lives in Seattle. I got to give her a call and give her a hard time. Okay, so real important too, just like when you're making chili, don't just dump in the chili powder and the cumin at the end. Put it in more at the beginning when you're browning the ground beef or ground turkey or whatever you use, because that really can allow the flavors to develop. So I'm doing some oregano and fresh or dried thyme. There's nothing like fresh thyme, and it's really easy to use, and with mushrooms, it just works so well. So you just take some of the leaves and run your fingers down. They're so little, the leaves, they're so tender that you really don't even need to give them a chop. Is it just me or is like fresh thyme? I mean, it smells so good. Some dried herbs are actually, you know, like the dry oregano, is fine. But fresh rosemary and fresh thyme, fresh basil too, I guess most fresh herbs are better, of course they are, but fresh thyme for me just, I don't know, makes all the difference in the world. If you had dried, I wouldn't overdo it. Dried thyme, as in most cases with dried herbs, but dried thyme is really, really powerful, strong in flavor, so maybe just a quarter teaspoon or so. All right, in go our mushrooms. 8 ounces of sliced mushrooms. I'm just using the, thanks, Ann. The regular button mushrooms, but if you wanted to mix and use, you know, like the baby bellas and different mushrooms, that would be really nice for texture. And what I do is I just take a clean kitchen towel or paper towel and very gently wipe off the dirt. Don't need to run them over under water. And then just give them a rough chop. What else are we making today? We've got a new twist on chili. My husband Bob loves acorn squash, but I've never thought about making acorn squash soup, but I would imagine it's very similar to butternut squash soup, so we're going to be making some. And then we're also making a nice cowboy stew. I have not had stew yet this season. I'm kind of craving it. So now that those mushrooms are going, a little bit more of my oil, a little more salt and pepper. This is starting to smell really good. So I know a lot of people, because you know, the game is, you know, last weekend, a lot of people went to the game, of course. Not me, I didn't, but this weekend, not many people are going to the game. I heard there was only like 1,200 tickets available and the airfare was sky high. Yeah, Seattle fans grabbed up, you know, 99 point something of the tickets. So anyway, most people are gonna be sitting home or, you know, having game day parties at home. So if you're looking for some fun, different ideas, we are really putting a great show together. It's in the works right now for Friday for some last minute decorating and really good fun football munchies. Okay, so at this point, we're gonna add a couple tablespoons. Here we go, Ann. Use your teeth on that one. Kidding, I'm kidding. It's kind of stuck to the, did you get it? A couple tablespoons of sherry. Mushrooms and sherry go really well together. If you go heavy on that, it's not a big deal. The alcohol is going to cook off. We're just going to be left with some nice flavor. And then 6 cups of chicken, or if you want to keep this vegetarian, a vegetable stock. And a cup of quick cooking barley. So I'm going to throw that in. And this barley is just gonna thicken this whole thing. So I'm just gonna let that simmer for a little bit, and then we'll garnish with a little bit of fresh parsley to top it off. But wait till you see how thick and wonderful this soup slash stew turns out. So stick around, we're gonna get it simmering, and coming up, we're gonna talk about some fun things to do this weekend if you're thinking about remodeling or building a new home. We're also gonna make some more soups and stews. Cowboy stew. a new twist on chili and acorn squash soup. Plus, where do you go for really good soup? We've got an idea, so don't go anywhere. We'll be back.